Hello everyone. The 66AK2G EVM supports three different ways of booting U-Boot. In addition to the default method of booting from the SD card, you can boot through wired Ethernet, and you can also boot from SPI Flash. When booting from SPI Flash, it can either be from the SPI NOR Flash or the QSPI Flash. In this video, we'll show you how to boot the 66AK2G EVM using SPI NOR and QSPI Flash Boot. QSPI is a serial peripheral interface, like SPI, with the major difference being the ability to support quad read. QSPI uses four data lines for read compared to two lines used by the traditional SPI. On the K2G general purpose EVM, the SPI NOR is located at the top left corner of the picture shown, and the QSPI memory is at the top right. QSPI support for K2G was implemented in U-Boot 2016.05, and that is in the Processor SDK 3.0 release. The QSPI boot will need Processor SDK release 3.0 or later. In this video demo, Processor SDK release 4.2 is used. To boot from SPI Flash, the U-Boot.gph image needs to be programmed onto the SPI NOR. This file is part of the Processor SDK release and is found in the pre-built folder. We'll first need to have TFTP server set up and configure server IP and TFTP underscore root of the U-Boot environment variables. This will allow us to TFTP get the pre-built.gph file to the EVM memory. Once these are set up and you are at the U-Boot prompt, run the U-Boot script get underscore U-Boot underscore net to retrieve the file, and burn underscore U-Boot underscore SPI to program the NOR flash. Once the programming is completed, we need to power off the EVM, change the SW3 DIP switch to QSPI 48 boot. Please check the K2G general purpose EVM TRM for the correct pin settings. Power on the EVM and the LCD should show QSPI 48 boot. To boot from QSPI Flash, the U-Boot SPL image needs to be programmed onto the QSPI Flash. The first 1 megabyte of the QSPI Flash is partitioned to store the U-Boot SPL operating system. That is, the pre-built image of the MLO file found in the Processor SDK release. Let's take a look at the EVM console to see how to program it. The MLO file can be retrieved either from the SD card or from the network, that is, through TFTP. To retrieve from the SD card, we need to make sure the MMC is responding by rescanning it. Then, we load the MLO file from MMC using the fatload command. To retrieve the file from the network, the TFTP server needs to be set up, and server IP and IP address of the U-Boot environment variables needs to be set. Then, TFTP the pre-built MLO file from the TFTP server. After loading the U-Boot MLO file to the memory, use the sfprobe command to initialize the flash. Then, erase the content in QSPI Flash using the sferase command. Please note that the flash size to be erased needs to be rounded up to the next 64 kilobytes. That is, for a file size of 499788 bytes, 7A04C hex, we'll round it up to hex 80000. Finally, burn the image to the QSPI flash using the sfwrite command. Once the programming is complete, power off the EVM, change the SW3 DIP switch to QSPI 96 boot. Please check the K2G General Purpose EVM TRM for correct pin settings. Power on the EVM and the LCD should show QSPI 96 boot. The EVM will boot to the U-Boot prompt, where the U-Boot environment variables can be configured accordingly to boot the kernel. In this console capture, the network boot is used with the NFS mounted file system. With this kernel boot option, the U-Boot environment variables boot, server IP, NFS root, and TFTP route need to be configured at the uboot prompt. Once configured, the system will be able to boot to the kernel prompt. This concludes the demonstration for booting from SPI QSPI for the 66AK2G EVM. Additional information is provided here for reference. Thank you for taking the time to watch this demonstration. If you have any questions, please post them on the Texas Instruments E2E forum at e2e.ti.com.